MDOT's e-construction effort is designed to take full advantage of innovative technologies for Michigan's transportation construction industry. E-construction is a paperless approach to design and construct a project. It embraces state-of-the-art survey, design modeling, document workflows, storage, and digitally encrypted electronic signatures. Significant benefits are anticipated by MDOT, FHWA, design consultants, construction consultants, construction contractors, local agencies, auditors, and eventually suppliers, fabricators, manufacturers, and producers. Let's take a look at how e-construction is being used on one of MDOT's largest projects ever, the reconstruction of I-96 in Metro Detroit between Newburgh Road at I-275 and US 24, also known as Telegraph Road. The project is 7 miles long and includes 37 bridges.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming out to the site for today with us. My name is Rick McGowan, and this is Jerry Torreson, and we are members of the I-96 Reconstruction Project Team. Today we're going to be talking to you about some of the innovations and how we're leveraging technology out on our site, or not particularly on the 96 fix, but department-wide. And Jerry's going to talk to you a little bit about some of the, particularly the survey technology that we're implementing on the site.
Thanks, Rick. These are two types of the instruments that we're using out here on the site. One is a GNS rover that we're currently using for our subgrade to check the variances and making sure that the contractor is staying conformed to our standards and specifications out here. And the other one to my left is a TSP or total station that we're using for the tighter tolerances that we use on the stone grain. And with these two instruments out here, we have an advantage to keep up with the contractor with the ever-changing technologies that they're implementing on their site for their stringless paving operations. And with these two pieces of equipment that you see on either side of me, we're able to take all of the data that's in them, put them into our computer, and create and generate a grade sheet and or cut sheet to verify depths and make sure that the contractor is within the specifications that are set forth.
Thank you, Jerry. Now, basically, like Jerry was saying, we only have a couple of these devices allocated to this project, so those resources essentially get eaten up right away in the grading operation. But what we have, we're leveraging now, is our iPads as well as our computers. And on our computer, we have applications such as Adobe and SharePoint and ProjectWise, which we utilize to keep track of the project quantities along with some of the other things that we need to know about on the job. In Adobe, this is a display of our site here, and this particular log is showing or displaying the removal quantities that have been completed in the field. We have a comment feature set up here. The inspector can provide a comment or highlight over the particular item of work that was completed, and then he can export it out and sync it back up into a program which we use is called SharePoint. And on the SharePoint, what we utilize that for is to essentially track production and keep track of issues that arise in the field. It becomes more of a working form of documentation. The inspector can then go into SharePoint, have his working log stored in on his computer locally, and once he's done with his day, he can export the data via reference data directly to the SharePoint log. Then everybody can go ahead and see what is being done on a project in real time and any issues that might be related to the particular item or scope of work. From SharePoint, we pretty much take it into its final resting place, which is called ProjectWise. And ProjectWise is a location where we put all of our project documentations, be it inspector daily reports, estimates, contract modifications, or work orders, whatever specifically related to the job. We also have some of the our mobile technology here in the form of the iPad Air and other tablets on the site. What we use these for is to access programs like ProjectWise, Adobe, and SharePoint. And we have remote access capability through these devices, which allow us to sync up everything and keep everybody up to speed with what's going on the job. One of the key features that we found on these particular devices that have become very helpful is the ability to utilize FaceTime. And what FaceTime allows us to do is to call up an issue in the field, and then we can call up either a specialist, an engineer, or a designer, and inform them directly of what's going on in the field, And essentially that person through FaceTime is right there along with us at our side. And we can show them exactly what we're experiencing in the field so that issues can be resolved more efficiently and effectively.
Here's an example how I use the iPad today. I took a video out on site, and if you notice the boiling water coming up from the subgrade, I was able to capture that, bring it into the engineer so he can make the proper assessment to address the situation as promptly as possible.
So these are some of the new forms of technology that we're utilizing. Some of them are older forms that we've had before in the form of survey technology, but we're integrating and updating some of those resources. But this is all something, one of the main reasons why we continue to innovate and evolve the way we do business. And it's one of the things that is better, faster, cheaper, safer, and smarter.